Hey guys, welcome back on my YouTube channel. This is day 10 and guys, today I'm gonna talk about collections in Swift. Okay guys, so basically in Swift there are three kinds of collections, and first one is array, second one is set, and third one is dictionary. Okay, so we will see one by one. Okay, so let's jump on the topic. So guys, in the earlier sessions we have seen how we can use if else and loops, right? So the loops and the decision making statements are very useful. Actually I want to say these are the backbone of a language. Okay, loops and your if else. Okay, because most of the times you will use this decision making statements and loops. So after that we are going on the collections. Okay guys, so collection is what? Collection is nothing but it's a collection of similar elements, okay, and having the same time basically type basically. So there are three collections: array, set, and dictionaries. Okay, so guys, array is what? If we are talking about only an array, then array is nothing but it is a collection. It is a collection, right? It is a type of collection, but it is a ordered collection. Means your insertion order will be pre-reserved. Means if you are inserting three elements like 10, 12, 15, then those elements position will be after inserting 10, 12 and 15, right? Means there is a insertion order is pre-reserved, right? So if in which you are inserting, in which order you are inserting the data, on the basis of that order the data will be stored. Okay, clear to all of you? So guys, this is the whole about array, and array always stores the value what on the basis of index. Okay, and index always starts from zero, and the maximum index of the array will be always total elements minus one. Means how many elements are in the array minus one will be your maximum index, and the minimum index always starts from zero. Clear? So guys, why we use array? Why? Because if we want to store the similar kind of elements, right? So let's say, if you are not understanding, let's take one example to understand the array concept. Okay, so the concept is what guys? Let's say you are developing you know what, e-commerce kind of app. So in that app, if you are adding some items into cart, then how your cart can recognize how many items are added or which items are added, right? So if we are taking a variable like cart, right, so a variable can hold only a single value, right, as we have already seen in the earlier videos. So a variable can hold only a single value, right, but there may be a chance user can add multiple items in your cart. Then how will you hold the data? You can't. Why? Because a variable can hold a single value, right? So if user is adding three items in the cart or four items, then in that case your cart should be a array type. Clear to all of you? So this is the use case where you can use array, right? And your and whatever the item you are going to add in the cart, those will be in the ordered form. Okay, so if user is selected, first of all you know what, like juice, then the juice will be first, and after that other rest of the items will be there. Okay guys, so let's go on our you know what, playground, and let's understand how we can use the array. Okay, so just start the thing. Okay, so let's say we have a array variable. Okay, I have created a array variable, and I want to initialize a empty array. Are you getting my point? I want to create a empty array. Means initially that array will be empty, like your cart will be empty. So how we can do it? Just use this subscript brackets and pass your data type. Means of which kind of data this array is gonna hold. Okay, please clear this thing. Okay, so if you want to store only numbers, then you will define the type as integer. If you want to hold the data as, you know what, a string, then you will define the string so that it can store the multiple strings. Okay, in my case I'm using int, and after that you will put the parenthesis. Clear to all of you? So I think our empty array has been created. Now let's run it and check. Okay, so as you can see, it is not showing anything, right? And here, as you can see, it is showing the opening square bracket and closing square bracket, means we have created an empty array. Okay, so guys, I want to check how many elements are in this array. Okay, so because this is initially empty, then it should show a zero. Okay, so if I want to know the count, means total elements count within an array, then how we can count? Just print array, and first of all you will use your array variable. Okay, and after that you will call a method that is count, call a variable property that is count. Okay, so let's run it and check whether is it printing or not. Okay, so guys, as you can see, it is printing zero. Clear to all of you? Clear how we can count, how we can describe the count value of the elements of an array. Okay, so I hope clarity about it. Okay, so I have created a array without any elements. Okay, means empty array, right? So this is how we can determine the count. Okay, now I want to check whether actually I have created an array. Okay, and after 1000 lines of code, I want to know whether that array is still empty or not. Okay, means there may be a chance you have inserted the elements in between 1000 lines, but there may be also chance ki you have not given any value. Okay, and you want to check after 1000 of lines whether array is empty or not. Okay, so how will you do? Will you inspect all the 1000 lines? I don't think this is a recommended way. Okay, so without inspecting 1000 lines, we can do what? We can check like this: if your array variable dot is empty. Okay, so it is a property that is empty, and it's gonna return a bool value. Okay, so if your array is empty, then it's gonna return true, otherwise false. Clear to all of you? So let me print one statement here. So guys, let's copy it and paste it here. So guys, array is not empty, I can say. I hope clear to all of you. Okay, so let's run it and check what it is going to print. Okay, so guys, as you can see, array is empty. I hope clear to all of you, right? But now this is the first approach to create the array. Okay, now the second approach is what? I want to create an array. I want to create an array by giving some initial value to each element. Are you getting my point? By default, there are no any elements, right? But I want to create an array with 6 elements, and the initial value I want to put 0 of these 6 elements. Clear to all of you? How we can do it? Again, I'm going to create okay, so let me take one another variable, that is array where 1 is equals to, okay, and array, you will use array, and then you will use the constructor of array class. Okay, so here, as you can see, there is a constructor of repeating and count. Okay, so if you don't know about the constructor or init, don't worry about it. I will explain these things in the classes or a structure lecture. Okay, so for right now, you will write array, and you will open the parenthesis, and then you will enter your repeating value. Okay, so what is our repeating value? Let's say 0. Okay, and count will be how many elements you want to store. So I want to store 8 elements. Okay, so the add element, 8 elements will be added, and the repeating value will be 0, means all 8 elements will be 0. Okay, so So now let's print the count here. Okay, so I want to check the count, and I also want to check whether is it empty or not. So guys, as you can see, it is printing the count as 8 and the array is not empty. Clear to all of you? Now the next thing is what? Okay, I want to print that array variable, and I want to know what will be the output if I print the array variable. So as you can see, it is printing the whole array with square, with your subscript bracket, and the total elements are 6 and with the 8 and with the default value as 0. Okay, clear to all of you? So this is the second way, how you can add or you can create array with default values. Okay, clear? Now next way is what? I want to create array, but I want to give some initial values to each element, but the initial value will be different for each element. Means I have already some items, elements are there, I want to create array with those elements. Clear? So let's say we are creating a variable, okay, array where to, and okay, so how we can create? Just start and close your square brackets and put your elements, okay, in this way. Clear to all of you? So this is the way how you can create array variable with initial values of elements. Okay, now guys, again you can count with the count property or check with the is empty property. Clear? Now guys, let's say I want to print the array too. Okay, so first of all I will show you. Okay, as you can see, it is printing all the elements, right? So guys, as we have discussed in the earlier topics, we can define the data type of a variable at the time of variable declaration. Clear? So you can define in the each case the data type, like, so I'm creating an array of int, so you can give the data type like this. Okay, but if you are not defining, so as you know, Swift is a type inference, so the with the value it can justify what is the data type of a variable. Clear? So let me copy it, and you can put in the front of each these variables. Okay, so let me copy and paste it here. So as you can see, like this. Clear to all of you? Okay, so the recommended way is what? Each time you need to define the data type, so that the another programmer can understand what is the type of variable. Okay, and okay, so this is the array. Okay, so guys, if you want to add elements in array, okay, after declaration, if you want to add some elements into array, then how we can do it? Okay, so I'm gonna show you how you can insert a new element. Okay, so insert a new element. Clear? So let's say we have our array where, okay, our first one variable, and I want to insert a new element. So I will call a method that is append method. Okay, and you will pass your new element here. Clear? So let's say I want to add 679 in my this array variable. Okay, this empty array variable. Okay, clear? And after that, I want to count the two elements, and I want to print the array variable. Okay, so as you can see, it is printing one as the element count, and the element is this. Okay, clear? Now guys, let's add some further elements. Okay, like 6, 8, and then 779. Okay, so these are the elements. Let's run it and check. So guys, as you can see, total 3 and this. Okay, now guys, this is the thing how we can insert any element. Okay, but if I want to access element, then how we can access? Let's say I want to extract the value 678 from the array, and I want to store into another variable. Now how we can do it? Very simple. Take your variable, okay, simple where, and write your array variable name dot, and after that you can write the subscript brackets and within that subscript bracket you will pass the index value of the element which you want to access. Okay, so index will be what, guys? For the second element the index will be 1. Okay, so let's print the simple var. Okay, so simple var, and let's run it. So guys, as you can see, it is printing, say this line is printing 6, 7, 8, right, separately. Okay, and after that it is printing count. Okay, so I hope you are understanding the what is the concept here. Okay, so index value will be always starts from 0, as you know. So if our first element you want to access, then 0. If you want to access the last element, then count -1. Okay, clear to all of you? Let's say you don't know, after 1000 lines of code you don't know what is the last index of the array. Okay, in that case how you can retrieve the value? Very simple. Count write array, you will copy this and you will write dot count -1. Okay, clear? So you will get the last index, and that last index will be passed here and the value will be extracted to simple var. Clear to all of you? Now guys, instead of printing simple var, you can directly copy this code and paste into print statement and you can run, so your output will be same. Okay, so guys, this is the way how you can access the values. Okay, let's say we have already inserted a value. Okay, and I want to modify that value. Okay, so first of all let me comment here accessing values. Okay, so guys, let's say we have already added a value and I want to modify that value. Okay, then how we can modify, guys? Very simple. Write your array variable name. Okay, and within the subscript bracket pass the value which you want to modify. So I want to modify 779. So what will be the index? Index will be 2. Okay guys, and after that you will pass on the index 2 you want to give the new value. Okay, so my new value is 899. Okay, so let's run it and check what will be the last value. 899, as you can see. Clear? So in this way you can modify the value. I hope now you have clear clarity about array. Okay, so this is what how you can modify values. Okay, so I think this is the whole thing about your array. Okay, okay, so please kindly, you know what I can say, do the practice so that each and everything will be clear to all of you. Clear? Now guys, I want to tell one more thing here, that is what concatenation of arrays. Okay, so how we can concat two arrays. Okay, so let's say I have array var and I want to add the elements of array var plus array var 2 and again I want to store into array var, right? So how we can do it? Just write here array var 2 plus is equals to array var 2. Now let's print array var. So as you can see, all its elements plus the elements of array var 2 are there. Okay, clear? So I hope clear to all of you. Now guys, I want to print or I want to iterate all the elements of array. Do you know what I am trying to say? What is the meaning of iteration? Iteration means I want to traverse all the elements one by one. Clear? I want to traverse all the elements one by one of an array. Then how we can do it? Let's see here. So as you can see how we can print all the elements, but it is printing with a square with the subscript brackets, right? But we don't want this. Okay, we want to access each and every element and we want to print with some string. Okay, then means I have to traverse all the elements, means I want to access all the elements separately. Clear? So how we can do it? We can use loops. Okay, so loops, I hope you have seen in the last video. Okay, so my loop will be start from where, guys? From where? Of course my loop will be start from the 0. Why? Because my 0 index, if I want to access the values, then I can access with the help of index. So my index will be starts from 0. Clear? So I will start my loop from 0 to up to what? up to count minus 1. Why? Because my max index will be what? Count minus 1. Of course, okay. So let me write array where dot count minus 1. Clear to all of you what I'm trying to say here? And after that, you will provide the body of the for loop. Okay, in this loop, you are getting what index of each value. Okay, and with the help of index, we can extract the value. Okay, so let's extract the value. So value is okay for which position index plus 1. Okay, why I'm doing it? Why? Because I want to represent the position, and position always represented in the form of 1, 2, 3, not 0, 1, 2, 3. Are you getting my point? So I am doing the index plus 1, and for this position, okay, is, and the value will be what, guys? The value will be array where, and I will pass the index here. Okay, so as you can see, now let's run it and check. So guys, as you can see, for one position 679, okay, so as you can see 679 and then 678 and so on. Okay, so in this way you can traverse all the elements. Okay, let's do the question. Okay, let's say we have we want to add all of the values of array, okay, and I want to print the sum. Okay, so how we can do it? First of all, I need to take the variable, okay, sum, and the value default is what, 0. Okay, so each and every time what I want to do here, I want to add the sum value, okay. So guys, I want to add the sum value plus my current array value. Okay, so my current array value I can get like this. Okay, and after that I want to print the sum. Okay, so let me print sum. So right guys, so you can print sum like this, and now let's run it. So guys, as you can see, sum is printing 25 and 35. Okay, 2535. Clear to all of you? I hope array is clear to all of you. And guys, I think there is no rest of the things are there for telling you. Okay, so please do the practice. Okay, and now we will move on the next topic, that is sets. Okay, so guys, sets and arrays are almost same, but there is only two differences. In the set, the insertion order is not pre-reserved. Clear? Means it doesn't maintain the order. Clear? And the each value will be unique. Means it doesn't store the duplicate values. Clear to all of you? So if you are storing the duplicate values, then it will discard the, it will store one time, but other will be discarded. Clear to all of you? So this is the thing you need to keep in mind. Okay, so if your requirement is to store duplicate values, then you can go through the arrays. If your requirement is that you want to store only the, you know what, unique values without mentioning the order, okay, means if your insertion order is not necessary to maintain, then in that case you can use the sets also. Okay, and the set can store the hashable type values. So I'm not going in the deep what is the hashable, what is the hash value. Okay, I will take one video only for hashable protocol. Okay, so for right now, just leave the hashable thing and just keep going on this with the set. Okay, so guys, how we can create an empty set, and then we will see how we can create the set with the array later. Okay, so let's jump on our playground and see how we can create the sets. Okay, so to create empty set, you will write like set, and after that you will define which kind of value set gonna store. Okay, and after that you will start the parenthesis and you will close the parenthesis. Okay, in the same way as we have checked whether the array is empty or not, you can check for set also. Clear? Almost the methods are same. Okay, for set and your array. Okay, so as you can count also the elements of the set in the same way as we have discussed in the array. Okay, so only this is the difference, that array set can store the unique values, and the insertion order is not pre-reserved. Okay, so let me run it and check. So guys, our output is ready. Okay, so as you can see guys, our set count is 0 and the array is empty, it is going to print. So instead of printing array is empty, we can print set is empty. Clear to all of you? So you can do like this. Okay, now run and check. Okay, so it is printing set is empty. I hope clear to all of you. So now guys, after watching all the things, how we can check whether set is empty or not and how to create a empty set, now we want to basically store some values into set. Okay, so how we can do it? So for let's say we have an array and with some values, and that array values I want to store into a set, okay, into an empty set. Then how we can do it? Or let's say we want to declare a set variable with some initial array values, then how we can do it? Okay, so let's create it. So let's take a variable like ab, and my ab variable is, I want to declare it as a set, and the set values will be of type int. Okay, and I want to initialize our array with some values. Okay guys, so let's say we have these values. Clear to all of you? Now guys, I want to check what is the count of ab and whether it is empty or not. Clear to all of you? Now let's say print, we are printing. So as you can see guys, it is printing 5. Why? Because we are having 5 values. Clear? So guys, this is the way how you can store array values into a set. Clear? Okay guys, so now let's say after declaring the set, if we want to add after declaration or after 100 or 2 or 200 lines of code, we want to add some additional values, then how we can do it? Okay, so let's say I want to add a single value. Okay, so what I need to do here, and I will do here ab dot insert. So I will call a method that is insert. Okay, and in this insert I can pass a hashable kind of value, means a value that is confirm our hashable protocol, right? So if you don't know about the hashable protocol, don't worry about it. Okay, we will use this insert method, okay, with int value. So if we are defining the set of string type, then it's gonna ask about string values. Clear? So let's pass a value, and this time I want to put 809. Okay, so let's count the values. Okay, so as you can see, values are 6. Clear to all of you? Now guys, after this I want to iterate all the values, or I want to traverse all the values of a set. Then how we can do it? I think if you know about the array, I think I has already discussed how we can traverse the array. In the same way, we can traverse the set also. Clear to all of you? Right? So let's traverse, let's print all the values by traversing. Okay, so if we want to traverse all the elements of set, then we need to use for each loop. Clear? We need to use what? For each loop guys. Okay, so how we can use the for each loop? Now guys, be careful, we are looking at a new loop, that is for each loop. Okay, in the previous I think in the loop session we have seen how we can use for loop, while loop, and repeat while. Okay, and there is one more loop, that is for each loop. Okay, that is very easy. Okay, so first of all you need to write for, and after that you will write okay, any variable you can take here, like element. Okay, and after that you will write in. Okay, so from where you want to fetch the element? Okay, from ab set. Okay, so I need to pass ab here. Clear to all of you? Means each time it will get a element from the ab collection. Clear? Each time it will get one element from the ab. Okay, ab set. So element could be any variable. Okay, you can pass I, index, or anything else. Okay, and let's print element. Okay, so let's run it. So guys, as you can see, it is going to print all the elements which are available in our set. I hope clear to all of you. Okay, so because the insertion order is not preserved, as you can see our 809 is storing before 7. Okay, I hope clear to all of you what I'm trying to say here. But now guys, if you want to sort all the elements of an array or a set, okay, so how we can do it? Just by calling a method that is sorted method, right? So let's call this method and let's run it. So guys, what is the problem here? Actually, after sorting, it's gonna return array, okay? So let me store that array, and that array will be A, and let me print A, okay? So as you can see guys, it is printing all the values into ascending order, right? So after sorting, it's gonna return. It's gonna return. Are you getting my point? Means first of all, this method will sort all the elements of AB variable, AB set. Okay. After sorting, it's gonna return. It's gonna return all the elements in the form of array. So our A variable can hold our array elements, and now we are fetching every time a new element from the array and we are trying to print. Clear? So this is the sorted method. I hope clear to all of you what I'm trying to say here. Okay, clear? Okay. So guys, let's jump on the next topic, that is our dictionaries. Okay, so guys, if you know about array set, then it's gonna very easy for you. Okay, so what is the thing is here, in the array the values are going to be stored in the form of indexes. Clear? In the form of indexes, where the indexes are predefined. Means our indexes will be from 0 and last index will be what guys? Total elements minus 1. Okay, so indexes are pre-reserved. Okay, means the indexes will be always a int value, right? But what if we want to define our on index? Means our value should be identified by some custom index. Are you getting my point? In other words, if you want to store the data in the key value pair, where key will be any kind of data type, or value type will be any kind of data type, then in that case we can use dictionaries. In the simple words, in other words, dictionaries are nothing but it's a collection of key value pairs. Clear? Clear to all of you? Now let's do one example. Okay, so how we can define a dictionary? So first of all, let me take the variable, and the variable name is my dict. Okay, and I want to define what guys? Dictionary. So if you want to define a empty dictionary, then you will define like this, and you will define the data type of key here, and the data type of value will be here. Okay, so it would be string, it would be int string, or it could be any kind of variable data types. Okay, I hope clear to all of you what I'm trying to say here. Means our key will be of type a string and our value will be of type int. Clear? So this is a empty dictionary. So if we want to print total count of dictionary, then how we can do it? In the simple way as we have discussed in the set and array. So guys, as you can see, it is printing 0 for right now. Okay, so if we want to add element into dictionary, then how we can do it? By using our variable, and then within the subscript bracket you will pass the key which you want to store. Okay, so let's say my dictionary key is 1 and my value is 1. Okay, so as you can see, my key is in the form of a string where my value is int. Okay, so in the same way, if we want to store another key that is 2 and the value is 2, and let's run it. So as you can see guys, count is 2. Clear? I hope clear to all of you. Okay, value would be any value you can store. Okay, and any key you can store, but the key should be of type string if we are declaring the string, and if we are defining the data type of value int, then we can store the int. I hope clear to all of you. Now guys, let's say we first of all, let me comment it also. This thing I need to comment. Okay, and after that come here once again. So guys, now after storing these two values, I want to let me comment it. I want to do what guys? I want to print I want to extract one value. Okay, so if you want to extract one value, then you should have the knowledge about the key of that value. Are you getting my point? Means let's say we want to extract the 24 value, then how we can do it? Just pass your dictionary here and with the dictionary within the subscript bracket you will pass your key of which key you want to access the value. Okay, so like this. Okay, now let's run it. So as you can see guys, it is printing 24 and it is printing as optional. Why? I will discuss in the optional data type. Okay, don't worry, I have remembered. So I will make a video only for optional, but not right now. After structure and classes we will study about the optional, so don't worry about it for right now. Okay, so as you can see it is printing 24. I hope clear to all of you. Now guys, let's say we have one another dictionary, that is security. Okay, and I'm defining the data type of this dictionary here. Okay, as you can see here I'm not defining the data type, but here I'm going to define the data type, and the data type will be dictionary type, and the value and key and value type will be here as string and string. Okay, I hope clear to all of you. Okay, so let me pass. Okay, if this is not required right now. Okay, so I can define like this. Okay, so this is the security, and within this security key dictionary I'm gonna store a key that is username. Okay, and same I will paste it here, and I will use here password. Okay, and within the username I want to store you know what, Swift, and within the password I want to store series. Okay, so this is the username and password, clear to all of you. Now guys, I want to iterate every value of this dictionary. Have you remember how we have extracted the values from this set? In the same way I want to extract all the values of this dictionary. How we can do it? How we can do it? Okay, so for that I will write 4, and you will pass a tuple here. Why? Because at a time you will get two things from a dictionary. First will be key, second will be your value. Okay, so in the form of tuple we can store. Okay, so I'm gonna write key, and second I'm gonna pass two variables, key and value. Okay, so each time it will get a key and a value from the dictionary. Okay, in and pass your dictionary here. Okay, so let's print. Okay, what is the problem? So we want to print key is equals to, and what is your key has been extracted, and in the same way value. Okay, we can print. I hope clear to all of you. Let's run it. So as you can see, key is 1 and value is 10. Okay, so as you can see guys, in this way you can traverse each and every element. Clear? So if we want to access a value, you should pass the key. Okay, if you want to print, or if you want to traverse all the elements of dictionary, you can traverse in this way. I hope clear to all of you. Now guys, okay, so if we want to extract only all the keys, then how we can do it? Very simple. First of all, you will take a variable, okay, and you will pass here. So I want to extract all the keys and I want to store in this variable. Okay, so as you know, there are multiple keys, means all the keys will be returned in the form of what guys? Of course, array. Okay, so my dict dot, and you will write keys. Okay, so it's gonna return an array of keys. Okay, so it's all the keys will be stored into this. Okay, you can give any value, you can give any variable name, sorry. Okay, so any variable name you can give, keys one or any. Okay, and after that, because this is array, then how we can iterate? Key in keys. Okay, and let's print all the key. Okay, so let's run it. So as you can see guys, 2 and 1, there are two values, 2 and 1. I hope clear to all of you. Okay, so this is the way. Okay, and one more thing guys, the dictionary's order is, dictionary is also not you know what, follow the orders, or you can say the order is not, insertion order is not preserved. Okay, in any order it can store the values. I hope clear to all of you. And the dictionary key type must be confirmed to hashable protocol. Okay, And what is the hashable protocol? Don't worry guys, I'm saying once again, I will make a separate video for hashable protocol only. Okay, so I hope dictionary is covered as well. So if you want to extract only values, then in the same way you can extract the values also. Okay, so let me copy and paste here, and instead of keys I can take values. Okay, so values. Okay, let me run it. You can make a value, okay, you can change it. So as you can see guys, it is printing values also. Okay, so guys, I hope you now right now you have a clear clarity about collections. Okay, how we can use, where we can use. So guys, if you are working with a lots of data or you want to store multiple data into a single variable, okay, in that case you can use collection. Okay, and in the collection there is an array. So with the help of array you can store multiple values of the same type, okay, where the insertion order is pre-reserved, means the insertion order will be same what you are going to follow for to insert the values. Okay, and another is set. So if you want to store multiple values where insertion order is not pre-reserved and you don't want to store the duplicate values, in that case you can use set. Clear? But if you want to store multiple values with separate index or with, you know what, your own key, then you can use dictionaries. Okay, so these are the three types of collections in Swift 5. Okay, so these are the basic. And so guys, if having any problem related to collection, you can comment in the comment section. Okay, I will try to resolve all the queries. And guys, for more videos, stay tuned. Thank you for watching this video. Kindly share this video with your friends. Like this video, hit the like button, and comment in the comment section. And subscribe the channel if you didn't subscribe it. Thank you for watching this video. Stay tuned. Happy coding. Have a good day.